So, good morning, friends. Let me welcome all of you who have come from different parts of India to our national capital, Delhi, at a time when the weather is supposed to be pretty friendly. And therefore, I am very happy that all of you could find time to be here to discuss something so important to all of us and to find out a solution to the problem which has become a common problem. And therefore, the strategies, the ideas we'll generate in the next 2 days will be helpful to us as well as those who are not present in the room but still travel by the train. When we travel, particularly by train, the passenger has many expectations from the system. He expects good service, whether it's food, linen, or whatever. He expects a good environment in which he travels. He expects a good price because he doesn't want to pay more than what he feels is reasonable. But above all, he wants to have more two major concerns. He wants all of this, but he's not going to compromise this in case he has to trade off this with safety or security. So for him, safety becomes far more important. The security becomes equally important, and therefore he wants to make sure that safety and security of travel takes a big priority over all other considerations. And therefore, it has become a very important issue globally. So how do you offer safety and security to the passengers? Safety is something which should be inbuilt into the system. There cannot be an add-on to safety. We cannot say that now we are running a system and now we are going to add on features of safety. Safety has to be an inbuilt part of a railway operating system. And therefore, this is a technology issue. This is a part of training. This is a part of making sure that we operate the system on a regular basis, keep doing all due diligences, and therefore, this is one part. So the safety we have seen over a period of time has improved considerably. There are countries like Japan where there is almost 100% safety, zero accident rate, and that is also because of the combination of this. So technology, manpower training, systems, procedures, ongoing audits, and that is what has made it possible. The security is far more complex issue. Because security is not something can be inbuilt into the system alone. It was, for a long time, we felt it was possible to have a secured railway system by way of building systems. But now what we are witnessing over a period of time is the externalities that are causing challenges to security. The security challenges are coming not only from within the railway system itself, but from the environment in which the railway operates. And therefore, the security challenges have become far more important and at the same time far more complex to deal with. And therefore, how do you deal with security challenges is going to be an extremely important issue. And therefore, it is very good that we have brought together for this 11th UIC World Security Congress people from different parts of the world, railways, the people who know about security, and to deliberate on this issue. As we have seen, the security threats is what is common to railway, not necessarily originate in the railway system itself. It manifests in railway because when the terror strike takes place, it affects the railways. But motivation may not be the railway itself. As we have seen, the people want to strike something which will hit at the society, hit at the government, hit at the people whom they are targeting very hard, and therefore they find railway as a target. Sometimes railway becomes a soft target, particularly a country like India where there is so much of population, so many people travel by railways, so it is very difficult to frisk each one of them, and therefore it becomes an opportunity for them because it's a soft target. But generally, the railways become a target as a result of an ideology, as a result of motivation, which need not necessarily originate in the railways. People want to hit at India. If they want to hit at India, the motivation may be completely different. They want to find out that India should not grow as it is growing now. We'll be one of the fastest growing economy in the world. growing at almost close to 8%, and as our Prime Minister policies are there, I'm sure we'll grow by about 10% in the next few years. And some countries may not like that India should grow like this. So the motivation is stall India's economic progress. Second part, India has become, despite the fact that we have so many ethnicities, so many multitude of people living here, so many faiths people practice, despite that we have a cohesive society. So people may not like that to happen, therefore they want to strike at us so that they will find that how can we create a divide between a society which has become a unified society for a long, long time, for hundreds of years. So that may be the motivation. So the motivation is different, and the manifestation of that motivation happens in the strike in the railways. So therefore, if you are dealing with security issues of railways, you cannot just do it only by looking at the precincts of the railway system as a whole, but must look at beyond it. Then it is not necessary that you can find out the threat challenges which are coming to the railways may be confined only to the national borders of India or national borders of any particular country. It may be that the strike takes place in country because always the strikes are local, but the motivation may be global. And therefore, we need to find out a global solution to this. And global solutions can come only through collaborations, through intelligence sharing, through ideas we generate, and therefore we need to find out. And that's why this global conference is extremely important. Now, when we look at security, one of the most primary important thing, as a professional police officer, Mr. Verma will say, is first you must know the threat perception. You cannot deal with threat unless you know the threat perception. You cannot create a security apparatus unless you know what is the threat perception. If the threat perceptions are so massive, then even a small little response in terms of security apparatus may not be proper. So what we really need to create a security response has to be commensurate with the security perception. On what basis you get security perception? Security perception can come only when you have an intelligence. The intelligence will be important to understand the perception. When it happens already, that's a reality. But if you want to know the perception, which will create an apparatus to deal with that, then you need intelligence. The intelligence has to be human, but more importantly now, the intelligence also has to be technological. And the technological intelligence that we need cannot again be confined to one single geographical border. When you use internet, you are not using internet only by saying that my internet is only confined to a particular country's border. It has become virtually a global highway of information, and therefore finding out a global relationship, global sharing of knowledge, global sharing of intelligence is extremely important, and that's why I'm saying this is an extremely important gathering for us. The threat perceptions having known, we need to create a security apparatus. The security apparatus also has a cost. If you create a security apparatus which is far more costlier than the main railway operation itself, it again becomes something which is not a viable alternative. So need to find out by using global knowledge how we can use the security which is commensurate with the threat, but also at the same time is something which will not be so expensive that we'll not be able to afford it. And therefore such type of global alliances will be helpful so that we can bring down the cost of creating the hardware of security. The software of security will come from intelligence sharing. The hardware of security will come in terms of type of hardware that we need to build, the type of gadgets we must have, and all of that must be done in a proper manner. One of the most important thing, and that's why we really need global cooperation, is that we are seeing over a period of last few decades, particularly the last decade, the security threats are coming because of ideology. People with misconceived ideological commitment, people are now trying to take to serious security issues. And that ideology is really global. What is happening if there is a hit in Syria, there is a hit in Moscow, there is a hit in Paris, there is a hit in somewhere else in the United States. These are all maybe geographically different people who are actually causing strike. Maybe different individual, they are a different individual. It is not possible that the same individual will go from Paris to London, London to other place and strike. But there is a common thread running between this, is what was the motivation for them to do it? And the motivation is common. What happened in Mumbai? The motivation was the same as to what happened in Paris. The Mumbai, the strike was railways. In Paris, it was pub. It was a theater. But ideology was the same. So unless we actually go to the root cause, find out how to deal with the motivation itself, we'll not be able to stop the terror strike in when it manifests. And therefore, bringing ideological issues, and that is another area in which I strongly feel you must deliberate about and find out how to prevent that motivation to be rising, how to arrest it at that stage itself, make sure that people understand it in the right perspective, and we do not fall prey to such false ideology which is causing the severe damage to the society as a whole. Why train targets? It is very simple. We transport a huge amount of goods by train all over the world, and therefore economic disruption is something with the motivation of these people who do it. Secondly, causing human loss, human damage is something which again people want. In India, of course, we are the largest transporters in terms of people, by transporting people. So therefore, obviously, if we disrupt that, we'll cause a huge benefit to the people because that is their objective, and therefore they try to do it. So train becomes a manifestation. So what, unless we look at our security experts globally, train, railways is something which is a receiving end of all this. But we should also find out what causes the beginning of a process which begins with ideological thought. And unless we start with that, then we'll not be able to stop a terrorist strike in railways or other places. So we really need holistic planning, holistic management, and I think we really need to look at it all in all perspective. In fact, I had to go to the parliament, and that reminds me that even our parliament was attacked. And that attack, fortunately, our security forces could thwart. But what was the idea? Not just economic progress to be halted, but also to halt democratic processes, to make sure that our parliament, which is the biggest democracy in the world, and where we really meet to discuss legislation, policies, how we represent the aspirations of 1.25 billion people. So that was also targeted. So that means the whole ideology is to make sure that the edifice on which the modern society is built, democracy, freedom, economic progress, security, all of that is the target of these terrorists. So we must work in unison. We must bring in global cooperation. And without global cooperation, it's not possible because, as I said, the origination of the idea itself is global. And if you try to look at it only, the manifestation of it, will not be able to get it. So terrorism is a global phenomena. Terrorist act is a local issue. It strikes locally, but the motivation comes globally. And that's why I'm very happy that all the people from different parts of the world are here. I'm very impressed with your presentation. So I'm sure we'll be able to get some very good benefits out of these ideas. We have very distinguished colleagues of mine who will talk to you about it. We attach very high importance to this issue. That's why even very senior official from the Prime Minister's office is here. We as a railways will definitely offer you all the help in terms of sharing ideas, but we'll also look forward to working with you very closely. I need to go to the parliament, so I need to go, but I'm very happy that all of you are here, and again, offer you my best wishes and welcome to our great country. Thank you very much.